Pod 28 includes an exciting update from Campus Solutions Financial Aid. We listened to the feedback from the financial aid community that the needs and requirements for determining cost of attendance budgets has become more complex over the years. In partnership with your FA advisory group, Oracle looked at the delivered process and discussed what would be the best avenue to provide users with dynamic tools to assist in budget assignment and budget item amount assignments. PUM 28 includes bug 3314-6531, equation engine functionality for budgets. This will allow for selective adoption of equation engine in the batch and online budget processes. The updates provided in this bug will allow financial aid offices to determine the amounts associated to a budget item code using a user-defined equation, to determine the budget item code assignment using a user-defined equation and a new equation-based processing rule for assignment, and it will allow financial aid offices to decide if or when they want to adopt this new functionality. This update incorporates two types of equations in the budgeting process. The first type of equation is a budget item amount equation. This equation is associated to the budget item code setup as a user-defined equation to determine the values assigned to the budget item amount, PEL annual amount, and PEL less than half annual amount. The second type of equation is a budget item code equation. This equation is associated to the budget category assignments setup. We'll review the setup changes for these options in a few moments in this video. The equations that can now be used as a part of your budget build process are all user defined. You will create your equations using the CS Equation Engine functionality. We've delivered two new application prompt IDs to use for FA budgets: FA budget item amount and FA budget item code. When creating your own equations, you'll want to associate these prompt IDs to their respective equations, as this is required for the equation to be recognized by the FA budgets process. On the setup page for budget item codes, we've added a new use equation checkbox. If you want to use an equation to determine the values for the amounts associated with this item code, you will check this option and a new search field will be visible where you can select the appropriate item amount equation. When using an equation to determine the item amounts, the amount fields are relabeled as estimates. This is because the actual amount assigned to that item code could vary from student to student, depending on the logic in your equation. When use equation is checked, the budget item amount, PEL amount, and PEL less than halftime amount fields are grayed out. That is another visual cue that the actual amounts assigned to the student with that item code is dependent upon the logic in your equation. When creating your equations, we recommend using them with new budget item codes. However, if you want to use equations with your existing budget item codes, we've added text to the budget item code setup page to give a notification if an item code has already been assigned to a student for that award year. Note that any changes made to an item code that's already been assigned onto a student's budget is not retroactively applied to that student's budget unless you rerun that student through budgets or update their budget online. With incorporating equations into your budget setup, you can elect to incorporate item code equations to determine the assignment of the item codes for a budget category. Note that budget formula, budget trees, and tuition all remain as options. The new equation processing rule option has been added to the budget category assignment setup. When the equation rule option is selected, a search field will be visible where you can select the appropriate item code equation for that category. Many of you may want to use amount equations and the values associated to the budget item codes and retain your use of the budget formula setup. We've updated the budget formula setup screen to aid in identifying if an item code is associated to an amount equation. If an item code is not associated to an amount equation, the budget formula setup page has no visible changes. If an item code is associated to an amount equation, you'll see some new labels on the page. You'll see an equation field that displays the name of the amount equation that is linked to that budget item code. You will also see that the amount field is updated to display as estimate amount, to give users a visual clue that the item code is tied to an amount equation. With the addition of equation functionality in the budgets process, we've made the following updates to the application pages in CS. We've made updates to the fields on the budget group setup page. We've added two new columns. If an item code is associated to an amount equation, the equation column will display the name of the amount equation from the item code setup. There will also be an option in the equation override column that allows users to indicate if for that budget group, they want to not use the equation tied to that item code. This option is only available for selection if the equation field is populated for that item code. The cost of attendance breakdown is now updated as estimated cost of attendance, as the use of amount equations could mean that students assigned to that budget group could have different cost of attendances based upon the output of the amount equations. We've updated the View Batch Budget Details page to include an equations column. If the item code assigned to the student is an item code associated to an amount equation, the equation name will be displayed. The rule column will also provide indication of the rule processing option that was used to determine the assignment for that budget category. We've added an equation column to the Maintain Term Budgets page to indicate to a user if an item code assigned is associated to an amount equation. We know that FA administrators will find it necessary to make updates to a student's budget directly on the Maintain Term Budgets page. If you are adding a budget item code that is associated to an amount equation, that equation will be executed and the output of that amount equation will be reflected in the amount fields for that item code. The equation functionality for budgets is also present in online budget creation. When building a student's budget online, we have updated the code so that the item codes associated to amount equations and budget category setup to the equation processing rule are executed. You will be able to see the item codes that were associated to amount equations and when the category was assigned by the equation processing rule. We have updated the output of the log files to display warnings if the assignment of an item code failed. We delivered sample equations, one budget item amount equation, and one budget item code equation. Because budget processing is dependent upon your institution's setup, these sample equations will not work as delivered for your budgeting needs. However, they are there to give you an example of how to develop your own equations for your needs. For additional information regarding the Campus Solutions budgets process, please visit the Campus Solutions People Book, Working with Equation Engine, Equation Engine Programmer's Guide, Setting Up Students' Budgets, and Working with Students' Budgets.